everyone, today we are going to learn the development of ear. So let's start from here. Here is the neural tube of median cephalon part, that is of hind brain, and the surface ectoderm surrounding it has a thickening called the otic placoid. Otic placoid converts to the otic pit and otic pit into otic vesicle. From the otic vesicle, the membranous labyrinth is formed. The membranous labyrinth is of inner ear. And here you can see the ventral part and the dorsal part of the otic vesicle. The ventral part has the cochlear part and the dorsal is the vestibular. Here you can see the cochlea is rounded in this structure. And here is the utricle, saccule and ampulla, semicircular ducts. So the parts of the membranous labyrinth of inner ear are cochlear duct, utricle and saccule and semicircular ducts. Next, we will see the bony labyrinth. The bony labyrinth is also a part of inner ear, but it's surrounding the membranous labyrinth. The bony labyrinth, here you can see it is surrounding the membranous labyrinth. It contains a three part, that is the cochlea, organ of Corti, and the vestibule and the semicircular canvas. It is supplied by the vestibular nerve, and here you can see the vestibular ganglia, which is taking the information from this membranous labyrinth. Membranous labyrinth is responsible for the hearing and equilibrium, and it is innervated by the peripheral process of the vestibular ganglion, which is also formed from the neural crystals. And it is peculiar that it is containing only bipolar cells throughout the life. Between the cartilage and the membranous labyrinth, there is a layer of periotic tissue which is filled by the perilymph. It is filled by perilymph in the bony labyrinth, and it is filled by the endolymph in the membranous labyrinth. We can remember it as membranous labyrinth is formed first and it is of inner layer, so it is made up of endolymph. And it is covered by the bony labyrinth, so the bony labyrinth contains the perilymph. Either side of the cochlear duct, we can see the scala tympani and the scala vestibuli. The scala vestibuli is continuous with the vestibule, which is a part of the bony labyrinth, and the scala tympani is continuous with the tympanic membrane here. Now let us see middle ear. Middle ear has the tympanic membrane and the three bones, malleus, incus, tapes. These are the first bones which are formed in our body. And here you can see, now let us check out the middle ear. In the middle ear, there is a tubotympanic recess, which is formed by the first pouch and second pouch, which are of endodermal origin, which we can learn in the pharyngeal arches. Now let us see about the pharyngeal arches. In the pharyngeal arches, you can see the first pouch, second pouch, third pouch, fourth pouch and the sixth pouch. The fifth pouch is usually absent. And the inner layer, you can see forming the pouches, which is of endodermal origin. And the outer, here you can see it is the clefts, which are of ectodermal origin. And the middle is of mesodermal origin. So from this, we are going to know how the middle ear is formed. From this, you can see the first and second pouch. From the first and second pouch, here the tubotympanic recess forms, which forming the middle ear. And here you can see the first cleft, which is of the external ear. These both fuse together. Now we'll learn about the external ear. External ear is formed by the first cleft. Even this is the structure of pharyngeal arches. Here in the pharyngeal arches, you can see the first cleft. So this first cleft is of ectodermal origin. So the external ear is of ectodermal origin, and the middle ear is of endodermal origin. Now let us see about the middle ear's bones, that is malleus, incus and tapes. Malleus, incus and tapes are at first individual, later they fuse with the tympanum, and here you can see, and it also fuses with the external acoustic meatus, that is nothing but the external ear. Next, let us see about the tympanic membrane. Tympanic membrane is made up of three layers, because here is the endoderm of the middle ear. As we already learned, middle ear is made up of endoderm, and the ectoderm of the external ear, as the external ear is made up of first cleft and the mesoderm in between them. So this is the structure of the tympanic membrane. Now let us review all the points of the ear. The external ear has the external acoustic meatus, which is formed of first cleft. First cleft is of ectodermal origin. Next, we have the pinna. Pinna is having the 6 hillocks, which is made up of 6 hillocks. Next, we are going to the middle ear. Middle ear has a tuber tympanic recess, that is also known as Eustachian tube, which is made up of first and second pouches. As a made up of pouches, it is endodermal origin. And next, we have the tympanic membrane of the middle ear, and it is of the ectodermal, mesodermal, and endodermal. As we already know, it is made up of ectodermal clefts, mesodermal. Tympanic membrane is made up of ectodermal clefts of external ear and mesoderm in between, and the endoderm of the pouches of the middle ear. Next, let us see about inner ear. Inner ear has the membranous labyrinth and the bony labyrinth. The membranous labyrinth is formed from the otic vesicles, and the bony labyrinth is formed from the otic capsule, that is nothing but surrounding it around the membranous labyrinth. It is containing the perilymph, and the membranous labyrinth is containing the endolymph. Now next, let us see the anomalies of the oral ear. The auricle or pinna is the outermost projection around the external acoustic meatus. It may be completely absent, partially, or it may be small, or as isolated nodules, or very small or very large. And next, the migration. The migration may be in the caudoventral, or it may be incompletely, and the mandibulofacial distrosses may be seen. Next, we have the external auditory meatus, and it may have stenosis in it, atresia, or the lumen may be closed by the fibrous tissue, by cartilage or by bone, and the curvature may be abnormal. And next, coming to the middle ear. In the middle ear, as we already see here, it is formed of this tuber tympanic first epidermal. In this middle ear, the ossicles, as we learn about ossicles, malus incessantiae, these ossicles may be abnormal, or they may be underdeveloped, or they may stick to one another or to the wall, and the stapes and these margins of fenestra vestibuli and the facial nerve bulge into the middle ear. The facial nerve may bulge because facial nerve supplies the first pharyngeal arch. And next, the stapedial artery may persist, which should be severe. Actually, stapedial arteries should be present only in the fetal life, but they may be persistent. And next, we are going to internal ear anomalies. Internal ear, we know the membranous labyrinth and the bony labyrinth. The membranous labyrinth may be underdeveloped, and the cochlea alone may be affected, or congenital deafness. Okay, so I hope you like this video. If you like it, please like, share, subscribe. Thank you.